The language of movement is written in feel, not in words and pictures, and I can prove it. Most babies get a command of walking without a lot of visual imagery or without a lot of verbal instruction. Now, that's not to say they don't hear the words and they don't see other people walking, but they must pattern themselves based on the way gravity feels, their center of mass over their base of support feels, and they work it out. And believe it or not, I think they actually do it as quick as they do it because nobody's coaching them and because nobody has a template of what a perfect squat or perfect step or perfect roll looks like. What do? They interact with their environment. Positive reinforcement, negative reinforcement, and failure. They basically go out into the environment, and babies don't repeat activities that don't give them positive reinforcement. They learn quickly from negative reinforcement and even quicker from pain. Aristotle said, life's greatest teacher is pain. You want to go a little bit deeper in this? Here's what I want you to know. When people do a movement screen, one of the first things I ask them is, which one of those movements was most difficult for you? And they'll say the push-up or the squat or the lunge. And the very first thing I ask them to make sure that they get where we're going is, do you think making it more difficult would help? Well, hell no. That was already hard enough the way it was. And that was a body weight movement screen of you using your own body weight in space. And yet somebody is waiting right over in the corner with a dumbbell, a kettlebell, a sandbag, or a band, or a rope that's gonna take that same movement that already gave you difficulty, it feels very difficult, and they're gonna make it more difficult. Is that really gonna help? When you can't read Dr. Seuss, I don't know if you're ready for War and Peace. It just doesn't work that way. And reading War and Peace, or at least struggling there, won't make you better at Dr. Seuss. I guess what I'm saying is that your own perspective of your movement has a big deal to do with how we train you. And I don't know how you feel, but I can definitely see when something's difficult for you by the struggle that you have to go through on a simple movement screen. I can find those patterns that are hard for you. The first thing we do is we don't need to stress those patterns anymore. We need to deconstruct them and sort of spoon feed them back to you because you got disorganized at some point. Now, one of the drills I think is very, very empowering to do for us and our clients is actually show somebody the movement patterns in a movement screen first, but don't talk to them about it. Just show them the shapes like squat, lunge, hurdle step that they got to get their body into. Get them to put some skin in the game. How do you think you're gonna do on these movements? And they're gonna say, oh, I'm gonna do great, or I'm gonna do horrible, or I know I can't do that one. Let them say what they wanna say, run them through the objective baseline. We've tried to make the FMS reliable and objective. Now, what's getting ready to happen is one of three distributions at the end of that movement screen. Their confidence about their movement is less than their reality, their confidence is more than their reality, or their confidence is easily matched to their reality. Now, if you move better than you think you do, there's a good chance you're not challenging yourself. If you move significantly worse than you think you do, you're probably gonna put yourself in a situation where you're not gonna benefit or even put yourself at risk. And if you know exactly how you're gonna move before you've ever gone through that movement screen, you're a good self-regulator, and not only do you read and write movement patterns good with your own body, you have that visual imagery that allows you to say, yeah, I can do that. So I think that one of the untapped things in movement screening and the way we look at movement is you got to get somebody's perception of movement before you do the screen, not after. And it really tells you if they're overambitious, underambitious, if they're going to challenge themselves, if they're going to overchallenge yourself. And I'd like to think if we did a little bit more of that, we'd have a lot better results than we do. We've been talking about fitness and making fitness videos for 30 years, and we haven't put a dent in obesity, low back pain, or female ACLs. We haven't done our job because we've converted something that we should feel into words and pictures without ever going back and changing the feel. When I make your push-up and squat less difficult, I don't need a lot of numbers, words, and pictures to tell you that. You tell me that. We should strive to movement screen and train functional movement that way.